manatees. Today's Mad Manatee Monday is actually coming to you from a new space. We are in the Studio 47 production space at Pomona College, and I'm really excited about that. We've got a green screen, though you can't see it right now. We've got this interview space that's behind me. So we've left you on a bit of a cliffhanger there. You've just seen episode 10. We're headed off to solve the great hashtag Where's Kimber conspiracy. What I realized is that, like, I've told individual people, you know, I've sort of given the end time spiel, but I've never actually had a chance to tell, you know, the viewers. Because I know that there are a lot of you. There are actually several hundred of you following us online. Thank you, all of you. I haven't met you in person. I haven't told you, you know, why am I doing this with my life? So I wanted to talk about what End Times is, what it's about. So who I am is I'm an aspiring screenwriter. I mean, I guess that End Times, you know, makes me a screenwriter, for real. In order to learn how to do something, I just need to do it. That was how I wanted to teach myself story as well. When I first came up with the pitch for End Times, it was me saying, you know, to a bunch of my friends who I had done youth theater with, I want to learn how to tell stories better, and I miss all of you guys, and I want to spend more time with you guys. Let's make a TV show. It took a little while to figure out that I was serious, I think. It was very much, you know, all of us flying by the seat of our pants. I had a camcorder that my parents had given me as a birthday gift a couple of years before. Auditions where I posted monologue and everyone just, you know, sent me in, like, videos that they had taken on, like, their camera phones. That first season was, an adventure, I guess. But, you know, by the end of it, we did actually have this series, and that was, you know, sort of this incredible moment for all of us. All of us, like, looking at this series and being like, what? Can you believe we actually did this? This is like a full movie's worth of content. I don't think we were as ambitious as I think we could have been in telling the story. It's very much, you know, just these small little encounters. And, you know, it takes a while to get started. And people, then when they were watching it, they said, I know who this character is. You don't need to keep, you know, spending another three episodes introducing me to them. And that's sort of my first lesson, you know? There were all of these things that I still needed to learn. The second one was a lot more understanding of how it worked. I had a better camera for the archive bits. I tried to get the story started a lot earlier. And the other thing that I think I realized, and that all of us realized, was that we could really use End Times as a way to, like, get out our thoughts about the world. And so you start to see a lot, you know, more serious themes developing in the second season. Now, by season three, I think we're doing some pretty cool, complex things with character development. But that's entirely because we have spent all of this time making the show and, you know, experimenting and figuring out what doesn't work. End Times is two stories at once. End Times is the story of five survivors in the apocalypse, but it's also about a group of young artists who just want to learn to tell a story. So coming up for you is episode 11. It's actually one of my favorites we've ever shot. I truly love it, and I think that it came from a place of all of us really loving these characters and loving the series, and so I'm excited to get to show it to you. And if you've watched to the end of this video, please let me know. Drop me a message in the comments with what your favorite moment from this season so far has been. And that's all I've got for now. Until the end, and don't forget to be passionate, creative, and a little bit mad.